Union Hill Baptist Church congregation now have reason to celebrate. On January 7th, the 4th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals vacated a permit to build a compressor station for the proposed Atlantic Coast Pipeline, citing a Virginia State Board for inadequately assessing its environmental justice impacts on the largely African-American community of Union Hill. Breaking through news was there for the beginning of Union Hill's battle with Dominion Energy's Atlantic Coast Pipeline and compressor station. It began with a Circle of Protection interfaith prayer vigil, which was held at Union Hill Baptist Church, where Paul Wilson is the pastor. The major threat was the compressor station, which was scheduled to be built near the church.
The Atlantic Coast Pipeline is a 600-plus mile pipeline that goes from West Virginia to North Carolina with a spur down towards the end of the line that goes off into the Tidewater, Virginia area. And we believe that this is an unnecessary line. They have one proposed compressor station for Virginia, which is in this immediate community, within walking distance, less than a mile from this church. We are at ground zero. We are a sacrificial zone. If anything goes wrong, we're automatically gone. These things do blow up.
Following the prayer vigil, the fight of Union Hill versus Dominion Energy received national attention when former U.S. Vice President Al Gore and Dr. William Barber of the Poor People's Campaign rallied in Buckingham County.
We're here to say to Union Hill, you are not standing alone. We are standing with you, and we will stand with you.
Union Hill shouldn't have to sell its heritage for what's right.
Two renowned activists marched last year with Virginia residents in Richmond against environmental racism. Former U.S. Vice President Al Gore's daughter, Corinna Gore, recently addressed more than 200 people during a rally against Dominion Energy's Atlantic Coast Pipeline, Mountain Valley Pipeline, and Buckingham County's proposed compressor station. Gore explained the group's objectives.
Demand that there not be a toxic compressor station in a historically African-American community called Union Hill.
William Barber III is the son of Reverend Dr. William Barber, the co-chair of the Poor People's Campaign. His son is the co-chair of the North Carolina Poor People's Campaign Ecological Justice Committee. He was among the leaders marching from the park across the Lee Bridge for another rally at Oregon Hill at Overlook.
Came here today to support, as the Poor People's Campaign and the Climate Reality Project, the local grassroots struggle of many of the community members of the Union Hill community, Buckingham community here, who are bringing attention to the devastating effects of the Atlantic Coast Pipeline, and specifically the compressor station that's being sited in a traditionally black community in the form of Union Hill. The same devastation, the same issues we talk about here in Virginia are happening in our rural communities in North Carolina.
Dewan Robinson is the Eastern Regional Director for Energy Affordability at the National Resources Defense Council. Robinson says the 4th U.S. Circuit Court of Appeals decision to vacate a permit to build Dominion Energy's proposed compressor station is a major public health victory for the people of Union Hill and a positive signal to countless communities on the front lines of environmental injustices from fossil fuel development.
When the land in these communities are undervalued, when your built environment treats you as less than, it is inevitable that companies and government move to locate dirty power facilities, toxic waste sites, and dangerous infrastructure projects to these areas, because powerful entities have less regard for the lives of black people, for the lives of brown people, for the lives of poor people, and for the lives of those who are less educated, because these people lack political power, and the majority in society have been treating minorities in society as less than for generations without much consequence, so why stop now? According to analysis conducted by the EPA and HUD, 70% of the country's contaminated waste sites or Superfund sites are located near low-income housing. 70%. This is environmental racism. These are deliberate acts, either intentionally targeting or, equally problematic, disproportionately impacting communities based on race. That's racism.
Richard Walker's family has owned property in Buckingham County for generations.
I am a fifth generation heir to this land. My great-great-grandfather, Taylor Harper, found it and got this land back in 1887 for $15. It's a total of 52 acres, of which Dominion is trying to seek an easement in order to connect from the current Transco line that comes across our property line to the new proposed Atlantic Coast pipeline and the compressor station. We're refusing to give them that to allow them to do it. Our family's been fighting for this land and continue to fight for this land. We have eight generations of Harpers that grew up on this land, and we refuse to allow big money, dirty money to come and take our land just because they think they can.
Elaine Rackley for Breaking Through News.